Fireball.
We're bringing it back.
Fireball.
You got it.
Streaming it right now on Facebook. Oh, by the way.
Oh, by the way.
Oh, by the way.
So, you know, when we go out there, we have to go out and troll for guests a lot of times.
You know, actually, first and foremost, what we do, we go out there with Fireball and give them shots.
Yes.
And then they say, hey, you guys are pretty cool. What do you guys do? And we say, we got a radio show with your shot.
So, from Firefly, which is a photography and audio-visual type of things, we have, Mat Kee. Is that, the one I'm going to struggle with here is Courtney Eatsy. Is that, did I do well?
Eatsy?
Boy.
Close. It's Yetsy.
Yetsy. I'll get it right.
He was trying to get the Spanish pronunciation.
I want you to look at how that's spelled.
Let me see.
Yetsy.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, I was at Etsy in a heartbeat. Yeah.
Okay. So anyway, we were on the bus and we met this wonderful duo, and they do photography for realtors.
Yes.
And probably other trades, I'm sure, as well.
So. Absolutely.
So tell a little bit about your background, how you got started.
Well, real estate's one of our primary focuses that we stay on, but we do other things as far as environmental work, construction. Last May, we had all the issues with the flooding, obviously. Unfortunately, this year we were in Wales shooting castles, but...
Really?
Yeah, so we do a lot of things other than photography.
So is that something you do for yourself when you're over there taking castles, or somebody employed?
Oh, yeah, for Wales was for fun. Okay. We were over there, my wife, and getting our son christened, so... But when you're out, you know, in Wales and there's castles, you got to get up there.
You got to take pictures.
Absolutely.
You have to get out there, absolutely.
So, well, how'd you get started on the real estate side?
Well, real estate, I mean, you get on Google, everybody's doing the real estate side. And we had a bit of a different vision for what we could do with the drones themselves, instead of just going up and taking a still frame picture, but actually being able to put a video together that's a marketing piece for the real estate agent, and be able to get all the things out of it, custom music, doing your banners, things like that, to really bring the life of the home.
Yeah,
you know,
I know a lot of people have been using drones. I've been following the drones situation because they're, you know,
the situation.
What else do you call it?
Yeah, absolutely. It's a
FAA. And I found out, and I thought, well, why are they making such a big deal about these drones? I said, mm-hmm. So then someone said, well, they can go up to 4,000 feet in the air.
Right, absolutely.
I had no idea that they go that high. And so we have a lot of things with the FAA, and that people are getting, I guess, what they call waivers right now.
333 exemption.
333 exemption, so they can... But you still have to have somebody that's a pilot involved. And
absolutely.
I think it's going to morph into where they can actually go out and train just on the drones and not have to go get a full license?
No, I would assume that. I haven't seen anything either direction, but it would make sense to me that as of now, you do need to have a pilot's license.
And a spotter.
Yes, and a spotter. And maintain line of sight. And there's a lot of things that are involved in this that, you know, if you're not up to date on what's going on, you could very easily go out and do things that are illegal or unsafe. Illegal is much easier to do, actually, than unsafe, because people go out and take pictures of, you know, just take your picture of the house, and we want a nice aerial shot. But if you have, you know, all your different friends in that picture of their homes, and you don't have their...
Yeah, there's a lot of privacy issues with
this.
I mean, there's of course, there are safety issues, but...
But what is really neat, though, is the way it... I mean, it's brought a whole new dimension as to the way you look at real estate, the way you look at homes.
Oh, absolutely.
Being able to see something, I mean, being able to do a shot in which it's coming into the subdivision, it shows, you get a little pan out, see what's around it, you know, see where, you know, I've even seen some that even pan out and, you know, will go towards what the main street is on the entrance. I mean,
absolutely.
It really adds a new dimension. Let's face it, a lot of buyers find homes on the internet. They start off on the internet, whether that be HAR, hopefully, or Zillow or one of the other items right there. But then once that happens, what they end up doing is they see those nice shots, they see where they're coming in from, they see what the home looks like on AeroView, and they want to click in and get deeper inside that.
Absolutely.
Yeah, they want a good idea what that. Well, look why Google Earth got to be so popular.
Absolutely.
You got to look at the street scenes. You got to look at the aerial shots. You can get down up and close. And, you know, it gives them a really better idea than just seeing mm-hmm. that still shot of the elevation.
Right. And with Firefly, what we, you know, we do the drone thing, but we use UAV so that people don't think all we do is drones. But we do a lot of the video coming in and out of the neighborhoods and focusing on things that might be a selling point of that area with other types of equipment. And as well, you know, going through the homes and getting a full idea of what the floor plan is to really show off the property.
Yeah, I've seen some other programs come out that, you know, it's getting so much that, you know, buyers can actually look at everything now because there's some programs out there that actually are doing three-dimensional floor plans. Mm-hmm. I'm sure you've probably seen them at the trade shows and stuff like that. And so people are going to get a great idea of the depth and the scope of where they're moving to without ever having to go there.
Right. Yeah. And that's the idea, is to try and save realtors and everyone some time, you know.
There's also some times that you're listing or an agent might be listing something that's harder to get to. You know, there are locations that are outside of Houston, they're on long roads or whatever it might be. And so it's the ability to be able to show something that you might not be able to get to or show somebody traditionally in a car, whatever it might be right there. So, you know, I guess, how have you gone about growing your business? I guess, obviously, you're on the radio show right now.
So yeah, we're on the radio show, so that's a good start.
and hanging out on buses.
Let's give a shout-out to the person who put this all together, by the way. The fabulous Tammy Nigro is the friend in common
Tammy.
We have.
Yes, thank you, Tammy.
And we met recently through her at our favorite restaurant, the HB Steakhouse in Humble.
That's right.
And we were very happy to meet you guys last week. You guys just jumped right in. I mean, next thing you know, you're on the bus with us, and we love
it. It's been a seven-day.
Right. Well, if you want to meet some realtors, you've come to the right place because we can
excellent.
We know a couple. Introduce you to some realtors.
Know a couple. Yeah,
we know a few. Just a few, right?
And you know, we have the a live stream going right now. I don't know why this came to me, but we have Lisa Mason Shaver, Teresa Fair is watching, Susan Statsney is watching, Tammy Downey is watching, Tammy Nigro.
Everyone out there, huh?
So, Facebook Live.
That might be a new thing we're starting to do. Facebook Live, go out there, see it. And we got the great Tim O'Neill filming all of us, by the way.
And it cost zero. You know how much equipment we had to buy to do this?
Well,
none.
I like that. I like it. So, well, technology has changed everything. It certainly has changed photography.
Absolutely.
My dad was a professional photographer, and I wish he had lived long enough to see all. I think he would have loved it. He loved new stuff, new gadgets, and stuff like that. But it's just phenomenal. And I remember my first little digital camera I bought, it was like Kodak, it was $900. Mm-hmm. It was awful.
And now your cell phone takes better pictures than that.
Oh, my gosh, yes. Well, you know, Chris has got that iPhone, the 6.
The 6S, yes.
And it takes
plus
fabulous pictures.
Mophie. Yes, with the Mophie on it on top. Same thing Tim's filming off of right there, so... Yeah, we're both big time
does
into
that come
the
with
Apple
a handle
products.
To carry it around.
Almost, yeah, it's actually not that bad, right? Like a suitcase.
We're gonna go back to like the old brick. Remember the brick?
Yeah,
yeah. They got smaller and smaller and smaller. Now they're getting bigger and bigger and bigger.
But you know, I give you an example though. Firefly, you go out there and you do something. Now I'm able to show them your videos on my phone, and now you're carrying something around that somebody can see. They look at it. It's high definition. I mean, it's all that stuff that individuals want to look at. So let's face it, how many times are you sitting in a place, somebody's on their phone, they're looking through things.
Absolutely.
You're at a Starbucks, they're looking at their phone. It's amazing how technology has really changed what we look at, how we look at, and the type of services that need to be provided.
Because Canon and other manufacturers of cameras, their sales have plummeted
because
of cell phones.
Yeah, 12-megapixel camera on your...
On your cell phone.
Yeah.
And that was the one thing when I would travel and I want to have a photograph. You'd always have to carry around all this stuff, right?
Which 9 lenses do you want to take with you on this trip?
And I still have one of those cameras, but I probably hadn't used it in probably a year.
Mm-hmm. Woe be unto you if you get a drop of water on it, too.
Yeah, absolutely. One grain of sand, it's over. Yeah, there goes $1,700.
That's when the camera's gone.
Anyway, I guess what precipitated you wanting to get into the real estate side as opposed to some other things, a lot of people do portrait or do the...
Mm-hmm, Well, I was doing environmental work, and what they would do, there's oil spill, you know, they call out a helicopter, $10,000, give or take, a day to come out and take 2 or 3 still frames. And it occurred to me, why don't we put a drone in the air, you know, and I can live feed, you can watch all this information live, and we can gather so much more information. And instead of 3, you know, people seeing it, everybody can see it. And then, obviously, you get on YouTube or Google and you start seeing the real estate side. And I didn't think that people were really taking full advantage of the technology that was out there. So we felt that, you know, it just flowed. It made sense to take what we were already working on and use different type of cameras to get the full real estate side done.
Sometimes the way to go in life is the way life is going.
Absolutely. And absolutely.
That's awesome, because I do know that a lot of roofers are starting to look at the drones, because, you know, getting up on a roof, especially if it's been raining, is pretty dangerous. So they're starting to incorporate that into their business, do roof inspections, and then give an opinion.
And insurance. When the floods were coming through, we were going and getting footage of communities so that if there were any type of disputes, we would have that ready for both sides.
Disputes and the insurance? What?
Never.
What now?
You were a former adjuster.
It's all explained right there in the contract. How could there possibly be a dispute?
Because nobody reads that stuff. the big print giveth and the small print taketh away. We know how insurance works, you know.
Yeah, I was like, didn't you read it? I only send you like 105-page, you know, policy binder. You know,
please direct your attention to Article 6.439. <Right. laughs>
Subsect.
Where it clearly
subsect
states.
Of something. So. Oh, look at that. I got the one finger. Look at that. I got it right there.
Which one?
I got it.
1 minute.
I got the finger right in the video, by the way. It was like that. Yeah, so.
And everybody remember, we have the Preakness this afternoon. We're about to wrap this up, but we got Nyquist going for the second leg of the Triple Crown today, about 5:30, something like that. So
yep, that sure is correct. Well, you know, before we do so,
stakes.
How can we reach you if you don't mind?
FireflyUAV.com. You can check us out on our website or on Facebook, Firefly Space UAV. Or you can hit us up on email, info@fireflyuav.com.
My man.
That is Firefly. Hey, how did everything go with that contest, by the way, as far as the picture?
Oh, well, we couldn't publish all of the pictures we received. But,
We did.
It was a great time, and I think everybody got into it. So check those out from the Rat Pack when we went out Thursday.
I want
Thursday.
You to email me the other ones you can't show.
Yeah, absolutely. I would agree right there. You know, we're up against time. Like to everybody, we'd like to leave with a good quote. Today's no different. Nothing is impossible. The word itself says, I'm possible. Until next time, we are out.
You've been listening to the Real Estate Rat Pack. The Real Estate Rat Pack is ready to answer your toughest questions. So tune in to the really big show every Saturday at 9 a.m. right here on 100.7 The Word, KKHT.